Everybody, my name is Abdullah, and today I'm going to be showing you my homework. And in this Python homework, I'm going to be doing task 1 and task 2. And so let's start. So in task 1, I had to create a function in which I have to use if and else, if or else. So in this function, I did if, this is the function. So if y, so there's a y from here. If y equal to or greater than 0, print positive number. It's going to detect if the number from over here is positive or negative in function. So if y is greater than or equals to 0, it's going to print positive. And it will say, like, see, over here there's a positive. It'll say 4 is positive number. Else, it's going to print minus 2 is negative number because that's negative. Let's run it. 4 is positive number, minus 2 is negative. So this is the task one. Now for, I made two extra work. So in this two extra work, over here, I did the same thing over here, but it's gonna ask your input. So if I run it, so now it will say enter negative or positive integer. Let's start with entering a positive one. See, it will say it's a positive number. Let's do one more. Let's do a negative this one. No, minus 5. See, negative number. So this is how this works. And now on to one more of my extra homework. In this extra homework, it will detect if it's a decimal or it's an integer. So over here, false equals decimal and true equals integer. So if it prints true here, it will say it's an integer. If it's false, it's a decimal. So let's run it. Oh, wait, but let me explain it first. So now over here, this is going to ask you for the same, input. So it's going to ask you in that box, like this one. It's going to ask you a number. And it will ask you for a decimal integer. So now I put float here. The reason because as float takes like normal integers. So if you just put 5, it will think it's 5.00. So that's why float. If I put integer and if I int over here and I put a decimal, it will detect it's wrong. So this is why the reason I'm using float here and over here. So whatever number I put in here, it's gonna come in here. And then that number will turn into an integer. That means it will round off to the nearest integer. So example, I put 3.63 here. 3.63 minus, round off, it will be 4. So 3.63 minus 4 equal 0? No, it doesn't equal 0. So that's why it's going to print false. So let's try. Let's start off by printing an integer. Close that. There you go. And now let's run this. So false equals decimal, true equals integer. Let's start with an integer. That's true. Okay, 5 is true. Now start. Let's start with a decimal. 0.6. There we go. That's false. So there we go. So this is one of my extra work. And over here, there's task 2. In task 2, I had to make like a class and object, and in class and a function. So this will, you know, detect for like cars. This is about like fast cars. So this will detect about type, color, engine, and speed. So self.type. So what kind of type it is, what kind of color it is, what kind of engine it is, and what's it like high, what's his highest speed. So now I'm doing Ferrari, Lamborghini, and Tesla. One fast cars. So let's start. I'm gonna write it. Over here I use concatenation. To make a whole sentence. So one fast car is a Ferrari. It comes in red, yellow, white, and many more colors. Ferrari's engine can go up to 800 horsepower. Its high speed is 211 miles per hour. And another fast car is a Lamborghini. It comes in 18 different colors. Lamborghini's engine can go up to 700 horsepower. Its high speed is 257 miles per hour, if you round it. And one fast car is a Tesla. It comes in 5 different colors. Tesla's engine can go up to 500 horsepower. Its highest speed is 200 miles per hour. So over here, Lamborghini is the fastest car. And now I also made this the dynamic way. So whatever a car, if you create a car object, so if you enter these things, there's def information. So what you're gonna, it's def for like, so over here, Ferrari dot information, if you write this, it will print this. So Ferrari dot information, whatever this is, it will print itself. Whatever like red and yellow, white, and many more colors, it will print itself. It will print itself. It will print itself. Okay, let's start. There we we go. The same thing that we've been here. But now it's like, so if you make a new one and we like put the name test of whatever, let's say Toyota.information, it will print that. So this is all my homework. Thank you everybody for joining me. Bye bye.